Hey guys, it's your boy Malik on Fleet 3.0 back at it again with another motherfucking video. And yo, I meant to make this video when the trailer came out, Spider-Man to the Spider-Verse 2. And bro, when I say I'm ready for this movie, for peak Spider-Man animation again, I'm ready for this movie, bro. And especially what I know for a fact is going to happen. Miles Morales and Gwen Stacy going to get together, my nigga. I've been waiting for this moment for a long time, bro, because I saw it in the comics. I remember they had a comics that showed the future of Gwen Stacy and Miles Morales getting together. And I've been waiting for this moment. And especially when I saw it in Spider-Man to the Spider-Verse, when they had them those little moments they had, bro. I've been ready for this movie. And as soon as they said this second movie was coming out and I saw the trailer, and you saw Miles have a book drawn about Gwen Stacy, bro, I was like, yes, yes, yes. If you pray, it will come about, bro. I've been waiting for this, and I can't wait. People are now getting on the bandwagon of Miles Morales and Gwen Stacy, but if you was a comic book nerd, you would already know this shit was going to happen eventually. This shit was going to happen eventually, my nigga. I made a video back. That's Miles Morales is one of my favorite Spider-Mans ever. Because he is. Because I love his power set. I love his suit. And I love what he fucking stands for. Because he has a different take into the Spider-Man world. You know? Anybody can be Spider-Man. Within the mask, you could be man, woman. Hold on, let me rephrase. I can't say woman. But you could be man. Any ethnicity, too. You could put yourself black man, Hispanic, white. Asian, anybody can put on the mask. And you got women versions too, but when it comes to the title of Spider-Man, I'm keeping in the man the realm of man. But anybody could be in there. When you finally got a black man as Spider-Man, bro, of course you're gonna have some swag. You already know. Everybody played the Miles Morales game when it came out for the PS4. You already know, yes sir. You already know when the Spider-Man 2, when you play as both Miles Morales and Peter Parker. Everybody's buying that game, bro. I ain't gonna cap. I'm gonna be pre-ordering that bitch, high key. But back to Gwen Stacy and Miles Morales. This was like when I first saw the comics about it, bro. It was interesting. Like I did not see it coming until I read the specific comic, which I can't remember the name of, honestly. But I remember the premise of it. So, Miles Morales, as you know, him and Gwen Stacy could go between the fucking dimensions to see each other and other Spider-Man. Ever since the Spider-Verse was ever created, and the multiverse was ever created in the comics. And Spider-Man was the first one to have a multiverse. Therefore, that's how everybody else from different Earths and stuff came about. With different versions of themselves, different versions of Iron Man, Thor, and all of them. But it was Spider-Man first that had this happen to him. And as you know, Miles Morales and Gwen Stacy hop between dimensions and everything. And this one time, Miles Morales was going to face, like, I think he was looking for his father. And he found an evil version of, evil adult version of himself. Oh, was it his father? I think it was the evil version of his father. And as they're looking for him, Gwen Stacy tags along. I think they were tag teaming, and they're going between dimensions. And at one point, they hit a dimension that everybody knows their identity, and everybody sees that Gwen Stacy and Miles Morales are married, and they had kids too because it was Spider-Ham. Because they went to a dimension with Spider-Ham in it, and he had their kids. And after that, I was like, damn, bro. This is actually a good fucking relationship. Honestly, I fuck with this. I fuck with this ship. And at the end of the comic, if I remember correctly, they decided to try it out, right? Not to date, but they kissed each other. And at that moment, they decided to just be friends for now. And that's how the comic book ended. From what, as I said this a while back, I used to be so into comics, but now I'm into anime and manga. So like, it's been a while since I've been in a comic. So if I look it up, I'll find out. I can see like what the relationship is now. But as in the Spider-Man to Spider-Verse 2 that's going to come out soon, I think next year or this year, they're going to dive into the Gwen Stacy and Miles Morales relationship, their dynamic and everything, and I am all for it. I am hyped for it. You don't see many interracial relationships. I mean, you do, but not in animation, if I'm being honest. I can't even count on my fingers the many interracial relationships I've seen, other than anime. But when it comes to animation itself, this is something interesting. Like, this is one of the things you never see. You got a black Hispanic going out with a white girl. That's crazy. Spider-Man will always be attracted to Gwen Stacy, from what I understand. First it was Peter Parker and Gwen Stacy, and now it's Miles Morales and Gwen Stacy. That's a pairing that you never knew. And I'm pretty sure Gwen Stacy in this universe, and I'm thinking the comics, is also older than Miles Morales by like a year probably. But I'm hyped. Like, I am hyped. Spider-Man 2099 is coming out, bro. You know, he's in the movie, bro. I'm hyped for that. And we may see different other Spider-Man again. We might maybe we'll have recurrent Spider-Man come back in. Maybe Peter B. Parker will come back into the universe. We'll never know until that movie comes out. And I am hyped. I will buy tickets immediately. Fuck COVID, my nigga. I will be there. I will watch this movie. Just like I did with Spider-Man No Way Home. Fuck COVID. I will be watching this movie. Strictly for this ship, to be honest. I mean, other than the story, because the story is going to be peak. The fucking animation is going to be peak. I'm more into the story about how they're going to put Miles Morales and Gwen Stacy. Maybe they're not going to get together in this movie, but it's going to be some kind of romantic feelings within this movie. 100% sure about that. I am 100% sure. You can quote me on that. There will be some type of relationship between these two. And I'm all for it. I love their dynamic. I love the swagger they put on the Spider-Man mythos. Because, you know, Peter Parker, you know, he's cool and all, but he doesn't have that swagger like Miles Morales and Gwen Stacy do to theirs. And the other Spider-Man, he is the original, but the other Spider-Man got their own twist on it. That's what makes him so cool and everything. That's what makes Spider-Man Spider-Man. Their responsibility, they were great. When great power comes great responsibility. I love it. There's not one Spider-Man I hate within the Spider-Man mythos. I shit you not. Superior Spider-Man, goated. Miles Morales, goated. Gwen Stacy, goated. Silk, double goated. It's crazy. But I'm hyped for this movie. And I can't wait for this relationship to be looked at. 100% sure. Because I shit you not, they're gonna be more shippers than me when it comes to this relationship. I shit you not. When the comic came out, I'm pretty sure everybody was shipping them too. 100% sure. I will not be the only one. Once this comes on the big screen and everybody see it, bro, everybody's gonna be asking for more. I promise you. This is a ship that nobody asked for. But it's what we needed. Since you know, this is going to be a great ass movie, and I can't wait for them to explore more of it. Gwen Stacy and Miles Morales, it's an interesting pairing, and I'm interested how they're going to deliver on it. That's the whole thing about movies, bro, and the comics. I'm always interested. That's all for me. Malik on Fleek 3.0 out.